Do you ever wish that I was, that I didn't transition, or that I stayed a woman somehow? Not that I ever, in my eyes, was a woman, but, you know.
Well, there's a different way to ask that question, I think. But so, do we ever wish that you weren't trans? That's one way. So you and I had that conversation just a few days ago.
Yeah.
You were like, I wish I wasn't trans because I wouldn't want to, I wouldn't wish anybody to go through the kind of, you know, square peg and round hole problem that happens when you have to be different than the mainstream society. You know, on the one hand, you were always different, and we had this conversation many times as a kid.
Yeah.
It wasn't, you know, if it wasn't, I mean, it wasn't related to there were a lot of other things you were different about. But my point is, it's hard to go through this. You know, nobody, I've spoken to parents, and I said, no kid, like, fakes being trans. This isn't something that you would want to do. It's hard. It's a difficult interaction with the society. It's a very marginalized kind of group. And so, would a parent wish that on their kid? No.
Right.
Do we miss... we don't miss anything of you because we have you. You're here.
Right. Well, I guess what I'm asking is more, do you miss who you thought I was going to be as a woman? Or who you thought I was as a girl?
You know what's amazing to me as I think about the answer to the question is how fast those mirages or images or ideas have been
shifted.
So I'm sure I had ideas of you as a businesswoman or as a scientist woman or whatever at some point, and a wife and a mother, but I can't see them now. It's kind of like the 5-year-old and earlier memories, you know, we kind of go, so they're... Yeah, that's kind of interesting. I don't really know what those. I'm sure I had them, but I really actually can't think of what they were. It was always just Skylar. Skylar's gonna, and you're doing the same stuff that I thought you would do. So it's not any difference, you know.
When I dream of you now, I only dream of you male.
That's cool. So we can put that in the sound. Can we put that sound in there? Okay. I think dreams are really weird. Sometimes in some of my dreams I'm suddenly back in like 2013 and my body is the way it was then, and it's a really confusing dream. It's very strange. And it's like, and I have now forgotten what it is like to have breasts. I mean, I've almost not had them for longer than I had them. You know what I mean? Like, I really only had breasts for junior, senior, and gap year.
Yeah.
And probably sophomore year too. So, but like, my point is, there will be a time where I will have not had them
for a lot of time.
Right. Then I had them, but so I forget. Like, if you ask me right now to envision it, it's very difficult for me to envision it. Not for like trauma's sake, just for like,
you know. Understand.
But in the dreams, it's so real, and I like. And it's so immediately confusing.
Unlike most of us who are dreaming that kind of, you know, in that situation, you're dreaming something that you have all of the muscle memory, I'll call it.
Right, and but that's what I'm saying. The muscle memory is so strange because I in some of the dreams, I'm like, what the? But it's all there.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, it's a very strange dream.
Very strange. Yeah.
And it's often about how people see me and how they are seeing me as I was then again, and that's a very, like a scary dream. Anyways.